Hello and welcome to Zach's Contraptions, your source for everything Rube Goldberg and chain reaction related. Today we'll be taking a closer look at one of my favorite contraptions I love to incorporate in my designs, the Newton's Cradle. Our first one is made out of boat buoys, which is fitting considering the nautical theme of the launch a boat machine. The buoys were excellent in size and shape. However, because they're designed to absorb impact, they really didn't work that well beyond the first hit. They really don't move too much after that initial hit, or in technical jargon, the energy almost instantly dissipated from the system. Still, I was able to use that minimal energy transfer to knock the stuffed dog over, activating the football launcher, eventually causing the kayak to crash into those coolers, and thus releasing our trapped salmon. Probably a good time to explain what even is a Newton's Cradle. Well, it's a device that uses a series of swinging balls to demonstrate both the conservation of momentum and the conservation of energy. It can also be thought of as a complex pendulum system. It's essentially an ornamental puzzle, commonly seen as a desktop toy, that consists of a frame where several metal balls are suspended in precise alignment, so that when one ball moves, it sets the other balls in motion as well. Depending on how you release the balls, as well as the number of balls you choose to release at one time, that will change the outcome of all the balls in motion due to having to conserve momentum and energy from the initial input. Rube Goldberg machines are all about taking everyday objects and using them in a different way, and Newton's cradles are no exception. So far, we've only looked at spears or balls to transfer the energy, but here you notice I just use bowling pins instead. When bowling, as the ball reaches the pins, you can easily notice that the pins fly about during that initial hit. Now that's due to an elastic collision whereby the energy from the bowling ball transfers to the bowling pin elastically, or rather similar to how a rubber ball would bounce as it's acting as it hits the floor. Now that means the bowling pins make an excellent substitute instead of the metal spheres to transfer energy in a Newton's Cradle contraption. Taking it one step further, this ESPN Newton's Cradle actually transfers energy completely differently than, well, any of my other Newton's Cradles I built. As the energy transfers through the bowling pins, it knocks the last pin off of a ledge, releasing a bowling ball suspended above. That then swings down to kick a football, thus continuing the machine. Just a cool example of how you can transform a contraption and use it for a different purpose. Another design using a Newton's Cradle came from my Open the Book outdoor machine. Instead of using the energy from the input immediately, or rather using the red ball to trigger something after the golden ball hit the others, the energy had to dissipate into all the balls first. If that doesn't quite make sense, then notice the bowling ball's movement the longer they are all in motion. As the outside balls begin to hit with less force, all five of the balls begin to swing further and further grouped together. In other words, the energy from the initial impact dissipates into all the other balls, causing greater translation, or i.e. greater motion in the system. By attaching a long rod and boot below the center ball, I was able to harness that change in motion in a unique fashion to surprise the audience, thinking the boot initially missed kicking over the block, where in reality it just took a couple swings to gather enough momentum. What if we could make a Newton's Cradle that requires no contact between the balls, but could still transfer the energy? Well, that's exactly what we did for the Google Rube Goldberg machine. Using magnets to repel one another, we were able to simulate how a Newton's Cradle normally acts without any physical contact. If you look closely, you can see the alternating colors, red into red, blue into blue, and so forth, which caused each of the magnets to repel as one rotated towards the next. As the final magnet was repelled, it pulled a pin, releasing the next step, allowing the machine to successfully continue. Our final Newton's Cradle example comes from probably one of the most famous Rube Goldberg machines ever built, and that's the OK Go machine. Built by the Zin Labs team in 2010, this machine had so many amazing elements that I personally feel that the Newton's Cradle seen here often gets overlooked. I think it's the best example we've seen of everyday objects being substituted in to create that classic Newton's Cradle effect. As you can see, a series of sledgehammers was used, which perfectly transfers the energy from the first hammer directly to the final hammer with such conservation of energy and momentum that it was able to knock over something as large as that file cabinet. Just truly a brilliant example and a great way to wrap up our video on Newton's Cradles. If you happen to have any brand new ideas on how I can incorporate another Newton's Cradle in a different manner in one of my future machines, let me know in the comments. Give a like if you learned something. Hopefully you've subscribed by now. And if not, go ahead and click that button, as it certainly helps me out. Otherwise, this has been Zach's Contraptions, and I'll see you next time.